Are you ready? Are you ready?
We are ready.
Because we're gonna go.
Ich bin ready.
Hey, look. You're live.
Oh no.
Oh, no.
Are we though? Actually, because my HP is -7 right now. Do I need to change that?
You guys can go ahead and put your HP back to full. You can do that.
Oh, full.
Oh,
okay.
We had a nice long rest.
Yeah, you had a nice long unintentional rest.
I almost put mine up to normal, but I waited for the call.
Good idea, but in this case, it's okay. And when you're done putting your HP back up, can you give me a constitution... just a constitution roll.
A roll, not a saving throw?
Just a roll. That was a save.
Sorry, man.
Oh my god, what?
Give me a roll.
That's bullshit.
That's even better.
It's better.
But that was a constitution save, too. You guys, stop doing constitution
saves. Oh, we're doing constitutions?
I said just a constitution roll.
I explicitly asked, too, and he clarified.
Yeah.
What are y'all doing?
Boners.
All right, constitution.
Boners.
Okay.
So, Nefmir is the first to wake up. You are laying on a pew, on a bench. Was that in game?
That was in character, yes.
I think so,
okay.
Yeah.
So you are in a large wooden room. You are laying on a wooden bench. In a place you don't recognize, an unfamiliar room. Although you are feeling physically spent, you do notice that your fairly grievous wounds from your encounter last time are nowhere to be seen. You are actually doing quite well. Looking around the room, you see your fellow adventurers on other pews, as well as a couple other people. And against the other wall, there is a middle-aged man kind of sitting on the floor against the wall. What do you do?
I'm going to walk up to him.
Up to the man?
And ask him how it's going. How is it going?
The man wakes up with a start. My God, my good God, you're awake. Thank Paylor. He stands up.
Yeah.
This is a temple of Paylor. I am Paylor's humble servant. Forgive me, my name is Yenbin. I'm the cleric of this town.
Well, Yenbin, it's a pleasure to meet you.
It's a pleasure to see you up and moving.
I'm assuming you had some hand in undoing our wounds.
At least I had all the hand in removing your wounds from you.
Ooh.
Speaking of which, I excuse me, you seem to be all right, but I must have dozed off. I need to check on your companions. And he proceeds to move around the room and check everyone, saying, like, "Oh, this young half-orc man, he seems to be doing all right. Oh, he is not." He looks very dejected. While he's moving around the room, the rest of you will begin waking up little by little as well. So you guys can start waking up and doing stuff while he's checking you guys. Oh, look. Your friends seem to be doing just fine. Thank Paylor for that.
That's lucky.
And this man was not so lucky.
No, really wasn't.
What is this place?
Oh, welcome back, my friend. This is the temple of Paylor in Windyboro, and you are lucky to be alive.
Did you bring us here?
I did. You were the only ones that I could save last night. I did manage to extinguish the remaining evil from that tavern, and I loaded you in my cart and we made it here, but you are all that I could save personally. We are safe in this temple. The undead cannot enter this sacred place. I'm not sure it matters anymore though. As I believe they have already gone. The town is basically empty.
I see.
Empty.
Is he telling the truth?
Oh, very much so. You understand perfectly that he is telling the truth. The undead came last evening, and they killed. And they took anyone that they could find. The town is almost empty now. He looks, if you take a good look at him, you can see his face is drawn and pale. He looks exhausted, like physically and mentally exhausted.
You should be proud, Cleric, that you were able to do so much. Those enemies we faced were very powerful.
And yet it was not enough.
Maybe so, but there will be more days for you to serve.
Serve who? My flock is gone. They've been taken.
Taken? What do you mean?
The number of bodies do not match the number of people in this town. I do believe that there are survivors and they were taken. For what reason, I have no idea. It's hard to believe, but I believe this might be the work of this self-proclaimed necromancer from the forest.
Fuck that guy.
This is the same man that everyone seemed to believe was just a madman, correct?
That would be the man, yes. I have spoken with him myself. He would, time to time, come to town for various supplies, which in itself is no crime. But many of this temple's children approached me with their concern. It seems he would brag to be a powerful necromancer and casually threaten harm to this village and our people. The town guards made light of their complaints, and thus they came to me. I made a point to speak with him, but while I did sense the vague remnants of necrotic power on him, I foolishly decided he was no threat. He seemed a man whose bark was worse than his bite, a fool on a fool's path. I misjudged him, and this is the result. Everything you have seen is the direct result of my failure to serve this town. However,
you don't have to take it all upon yourself. It sounds like the town guards and everything made their decision, and they equally share, or even more so. Sure, part of the blame.
The town guards are fools.
They got their just desserts.
I don't see the town guard around anymore. However, it may not be too late to prevent the worst case scenario. You will no doubt notice when you leave this temple the distinct lack of people. The dead have been taken. For what purpose, I don't know, and shudder to think. However, my larger concern is that for the living. These beasts captured whoever was unable to fight them off and have taken them. Considering the purpose brings bile to my throat, but I have to believe that they were kept alive for a reason, not to be simply killed later. But thank Paler. At least our dear friend Perrin was spared whatever fate awaits those dead.
Do you know of Perrin? Is his body still laying around anywhere?
I have taken his body from the tavern. He is safe from their intents.
Well, there's that at least.
He looks around the room, again, is extremely exhausted, but he has sort of a glint in his eyes. Please, would you help us? This town is a ghost of what it once was. No joke intended, friends. I have no idea how many were taken and how many even still live, but I beg you, would you lend us your power? Save them. We don't have much to offer, but the weapon merchant's family was taken, while he does remain. I'm sure he would want to help you if it meant the lives of his wife and daughter. The merchant you were traveling with, Perrin, Paler, arrest him, was also known for being a purveyor of goods. I know he had one or two that he was particularly proud of, and he certainly has no use for them anymore.
Well, even if such a goal was not something we would seek, even if we don't act, well, this person might come back for us.
He very well may. What say you? Will you help our town?
Well, I'm willing, but I have concerns about the strength of this person we face. I don't know if we're up to the challenge.
So, on that note, I do believe that if we move soon, we can help. The feat that he accomplished last evening, the sheer force that he arrived with, he cannot be healthy, to say the least. He cannot be at full power again. If we move quickly...
He needs rest, or...
I can't imagine him able to do anything without more rest. If we move right now, it could be okay. Mm-hmm. We could do something.
If what else did... do we know about this man?
Nothing. I know nothing at all. Only that when I saw him before, he seemed, to be frank, a weakling and a fool. But this is no action of a weakling. I don't know what has changed.
Please explain his physical appearance.
Yeah, was the man. He human?
He is human. He is a human man, fairly young. That also contributed to my idea that he was just a young fool. A young human man. He has black hair. He's fairly pale. The music just started looping again for some reason.
I heard that too. What's going on here?
Pretty weird, right? But anyway. Will you help?
And what kind of threats was he making in town?
Just a fool's threat, saying people who were mocking him. He believed that people mocked him, and he threatened our well-being for humiliating him so.
So, this man sought vengeance as a result of his mockery, perhaps?
I knew of no mockery, but perhaps that is his idea. I apologize, friends. I am as much in the dark as you at this point.
Well, at least we can go on the fact that if this guy is as sensitive and took, you know, little mockery as personally as he did, maybe he's not all necessarily that powerful and just kind of lashed out with what he had. We might be able to take this guy and take everything that he took from the town.
That would be more than I could ever hope for. What say the rest of you? Will you help us? Will you save this town?
I'm willing, yes. But,
yeah.
Where are we going to find this man?
Thank Paylor. Thank Paylor for you all. Truly the gods wish for us to right this wrong. Let's see.
Let me know which direction the undead left last night.
Ah, yes. It's a good start.
So, yes. So, to my knowledge, the necromancer had set up his operation in the abandoned ranger station to the east, and his beasts came from that direction as well, and it was in that direction that they returned. I don't know if he would return to such an obvious place after committing such a heinous act, but that is the only lead I have for you right now. If you do come across him and judge him to be too powerful, don't push yourselves. There is no more need for further sacrifice. I have sent word. That's right. I have sent word to the farthest ranger station to the east, the closest one to us. I have informed them of our situation and requested their full cooperation. I have yet to receive a response, but I do pray you will find them on the road and receive their assistance.
Is that not the station we visited?
Oh, what? You have visited a station already?
Yes, we... Yeah, I believe we went to the station you speak of. Is that correct,
we just
Whitmore?
In the mountains?
No, if it was in the mountains.
Ah, friends, there are two ranger stations to the east. There is one abandoned. The one that he had set up in was closer to us. And there is another... Sorry, there's a bug in my face. There is another further east that had pushed as far east as the rangers were able. They crested the mountains to the east and stopped there, building their furthest most outpost.
Ah, yes. We have not been to that one.
That is where you will find them.
I see. Well, then, should we head there, friends?
Let's stock up as much as possible first.
Seems to get as late as any.
Yes, of course. We'll see what provisions we can get.
Yenbin.
Yes.
Would you happen to have any provisions for us as we embark on this errand?
I have nothing here, but there are many places in the town that you can check. Many homes that, well, that are not going to need it anymore. One second. It might do you well to check the stables. I haven't had the chance myself, but on the chance that some horses do remain, they may help you get there in time to save those who yet live. The power required to animate such a force. My hope is that he will need the time to recover before he continues with whatever he has planned.
Well, my friends, if we are going to do this, we also, I think, with the worry that you have about his rest, perhaps we also need a plan to know when we need to leave, if we need to leave.
You mean to retreat when from to run him?
Yes. We don't want to be stuck in a situation like we did in the tavern again.
Correct.
Do you have any suggestions?
I vote that if we see a skeleton minotaur, we just leave immediately. But that's just me.
You know, as specific as a plan as that is, it's not a bad start.
I mean, maybe.
Yen Ben moves to this pew and sits down because he was starting to shake slightly.
Maybe if there's just a skeletal minotaur against all of us, maybe we can kill that, but...
This might be one of those situations where we have to judge as we go.
Yeah.
You fought the skeletal minotaur from last evening.
Fight is the strong word,
more,
my
more
friend.
Like it fought us.
I don't remember a skeletal word. Minotaur.
Yes, it was it was enormous.
What the fuck?
If I remember right, I think I told it to calm down or something. It didn't work.
I can tell you that it did not work at all. Oh.
Lena sighs with a bit of regret, but she's not wavering.
Well, this sounds jolly well grand. Let's go where we need to go.
Please, all right. At the very least, please do check. Oh, the music began again. At the very least, please do check with the weapons shop owner. I'm certain that he will outfit you with what you need.
Okay.
To be sure, we're not looting, correct? We are going to this shop
he
owner.
He is alive. He is alive. He does not wish to be, places, but he is.
We will be looting, but it's okay because they're dead.
If I can tell you the households that will no longer be requiring their goods. If it means saving the others of the town, it is for the best.
I would suggest that if we don't have to, we leave their things alone. If there's any use that the people who are still here or will be in the future can use anything, I think that would be best if we left it to them.
We will need all the help we get.
I think we are those people here right now. And we may be here in the future, so...
Yeah, I see what you mean. If it's necessary no for harm. Us, of course.
No foul.
Uh-huh. I'm giving him the side eye.
So Yenben outlines some simple directions as to how to get to the weapons shop. He tells you two homes specifically that he knows are going to be empty for the foreseeable future.
Okay.
So what will you do?
I think we should head to that weapons shop first.
Yes, okay. Let's stock up.
Okay.
Good luck, travelers.
Hey. You
May Paylor protect you all.
You guys go ahead. I gotta catch my breath for a second.
Oh.
Fair enough. Let's go.
I'll catch up with you later.
Fair enough.
And right. We'll head out, I guess.
Okay. So you're going to the weapons shop?
Mm-hmm.
1 second.
Stop piling.
Why not?
The pile.
Stop your piling.
The pile does not stop from becoming taller. Oh no.
Oops, I put you there, but I didn't go there. Hold on a second. One second, please.
This looks like it was made with that editor.
Hey, this is from Undertale.
Is it?
Yes.
I searched for music.
When like yeah, the first totally couple is. Notes started playing, I was like, "Huh, this sounds like Undertale, but it's not, right?"
It's a remix, but.
And then it was.
Oh, please ignore that then.
Well, hey, this is appropriate. This is fine.
So anyway,
I know some people that would be playing with would be very upset if they heard this right now.
And I'm sorry,
but it's
okay. I didn't.
But you're in good company.
Okay. I'm using the jukebox. I searched for quiet music. This is what I got.
So as in like, this is at Rule 20 put this up.
Yeah, it's a different website works with Rule 20.
That's pretty funny. Anyway, back to Vinci again.
All right, so you're not actually in the weapons shop just yet, so stop grabbing bones.
I'll grab as many bones as I want to.
Don't grab my
so
bones.
So you follow. Are you ready?
Get off of me.
So you follow the simple directions that Yenben provided.
That was in
passing,
character, by the way.
Okay, good. Passing through the streets, it is a far cry from the warm and simple happiness that you felt yesterday. The streets are cold and silent and empty. Bones from the fallen skeletons lay throughout the street, though they are few when compared to the bloodstains that were left behind. You arrive at the building that you recognize as the weapons shop. It's very easily accessible via the hole torn in the wall. The door has been torn off and lies in the street. The wall at the entrance has been partially toppled into the shop, and looking in, you see no one. Looking in, you see no one.
Oh, yeah.
Looking in, you see no one. What will you do? Do you want to go for the bones?
I want to look around for, like, blood stains.
Ooh.
Signs of struggle.
I mean, the whole shop is a sign of struggle. There is rubble everywhere. Goods are sort of knocked onto the floor. You can see the remnants of two skeletons that had been defeated lying up on the floor. No blood stains to speak of.
Okay.
So Remy's just digging through the bones.
Could I investigate, but also take the bones?
Investigate what?
Just what I see. To see if there's anything else.
So that's perception. Investigating is for something specific.
Okay, just perception.
Yeah. Yeah, you can roll perception then.
I think I will do the same.
Okay.
Did he not say that the weapons shop owner was still around?
As you speak, from behind the counter, you hear a loud grunt, as if someone has just woken up, and then a deep voice, "Shop's closed. May be that it never opens again. Leave me be."
What time of day was it when we walked outside? Like morning?
Morning. It's morning.
Sorry to startle you, sir. We didn't know you were in here.
Please, sir, help us help you.
Help us, Obi.
I don't know what you're talking about. Get the fuck out of here.
Do you know Cleric Yenben? He pointed at us to go in this direction.
Of course I know Cleric Yenben. You hear a loud grunt as a large half-orc man pulls himself up from the other side of the counter. You can see he is a middle-aged half-orc. Hold on a second. I lost the layer.
Also, don't forget to explain those perception rolls.
They're not necessary anymore.
Okay.
Nothing. You would have found him. That's all. So you hear a loud groan as two large hands grasp the edge of the counter and a half-orc man pulls himself to his feet. He is a middle-aged half-orc man. You can see an obvious disability. One leg is cut off at the thigh, but very long since healed over. This is not a recent wound. He has pale green skin, and he's got graying hair. He does have a fresh bandaged wound on his side. You can see blood soaking through the bandages. And he says, yes, I know Yen Ben. What did he send you to me for?
We are hoping to find the person who responsible for the carnage here and do something about it. And Yen Ben said that maybe we could get some weaponry from you, perhaps?
His face brightens immediately. You're going after him.
He
starts to like scan the party, and he zeroes in on Thought right away and says, "Oh, well, I'll be damned. I didn't think I'd see one of my brethren in these parts." And eyeing him up and down a little bit, one of his eyebrows rises in, you know, a little bit of judgment. A bit live, ain't you? Are you eating okay?
Yeah. This is just the way I am. You know.
His surprise fades slightly, and he seems to remember his situation.
Wait, but what makes you think you can save my girls?
I won't say that we...
We won't know. We won't know until we try. We won't get anywhere by not trying.
Right, we're also hoping to get the jump on him, you see.
Yes, if we go now, maybe we can catch him unaware.
He very likely used a lot of power to amass this attack. This is the best chance to strike.
You may be right. Well, I'm desperate enough for any help. You'll need good weapons and good weapons on my trade, friends.
He suddenly, sort of his eyes widen again in realization, and he turns back to look at Thought again.
Wait right here.
He hops off into his back room. He left. He went into the back room. He hops off into the back room, making a surprisingly good time. And returns after about a minute, holding an ornate sword in his hands, and he hops the counter. Whoops.
Whoa!
He becomes Nethmir. He hops the counter with one quick hop and lands right in front of Thought. And he kind of holds the sword out slightly. Thought, would you roll me an Arcana real quick? An Arcana check. Oh, look at that. Good job. So as he holds the sword out to you slightly, the hairs on the back of your neck stand up ever so slightly. You can feel magic emanating from the sword. He speaks with a very slight excitement in his voice, saying,
Do you like horses, son?
Not more than anyone else, I'd wager.
He holds a long sword in his hands. The silver hilt and black sheath are decorated with silver horses. Unsheathing it, you can see a black steel blade with gold inscriptions, some magical and some that are just more horse pictures. He holds it out to Thought and grins.
Try it.
I take the sword.
Step back.
As you take the sword in hand, you hear...
Nethmir does too.
As you take the sword in your hand, you hear a faint, disembodied... And you are overcome with an urge to run free in a field. Now, roll a constitution check.
Oh, no. I did really bad.
He's just
going to
start running around uncontrollably.
You manage to hold yourself in place, but a sound that is unmistakably a horse's whinny bursts from your mouth. Go ahead.
I have to do that?
You have to do.
What magic is this?
The half-orc man laughed. Yeah, you like horses. I knew you liked horses.
So while you are holding this sword, there's a, you know, you're feeling some very strange emotions, but you do feel more powerful while holding the sword. Energy is virtually bursting from your arms. The half-orc grins. How do you like it?
This is just unlike anything I've ever seen. I don't really know what to say.
It's called the Sword of 100 Horses. It has been magically imbued with the power of 100 distinct horses.
Sure,
she's a real
like
beaut, ain't she?
It's gorgeous.
And she's yours. If you can bring back my girls.
I swear to you, if it is in my capability, I will bring them back to you. If it is not, I will likely die.
He takes both arms and he claps them strongly on your shoulders. And he shakes his head and hands you the sheath of the sword with confidence. Turning back, he hops over the counter again and slams his hands down on the counter. So, you other capable types, my wares are open to you. What do you need?
A couple daggers would be fantastic, sir.
I got daggers, and you can just take them. Just take them. How many do you need? I've got three daggers on me.
I'll take them all.
Okay. I know it's for a good cause. Thank you so much for what you're doing.
Do you, sir, have you got any healing potions or anything of the like?
Oh, I'm sorry. Healing potions were never part of my normal wares, but I'm sure somewhere around town there'd be something. Any pretty weapons? I'm sorry, ma'am. My pretty weapons were never much in my wheelhouse. I'm sorry to say that my most gorgeous weapon is the one that your friend there holds now, and I had no part in making that.
You didn't make the sword?
Oh no, I bought it.
Oh.
No, I'm not what you'd call a magic type.
Oh, of course, but maybe you some smithing?
Oh, I do some smithing, but no magic.
Yes, yeah.
I like horses. So when I came across this sword, I felt like I just needed to have it. It was the crown of my personal collection, but my goodness, it's much more capable in hands like yours.
I hope so.
Well, I did just give my last three daggers to this man.
Remy, here, you can have one of mine.
Don't you have a mace?
You can talk too.
The mace is gonna be better for
right, those bones.
The bones? What? You mean these bones? Is your microphone not working?
It's working. It's just kind of loud in my room.
Oh, I don't hear anything.
Oh.
We'll let you know if it gets bad. The skeleton bones, you want them?
I do.
He looks extremely wary
Could I inquire as to why, little miss?
I just collect things.
You collect bones?
Sure.
I've been trying to get a straight answer out of her this whole time, and I just haven't gotten it yet.
I guess you could take these bones. I don't want them.
Okay.
Can I inspect one of the skeletons and see? I kind of want to know if like they're human and perhaps like. Well, first, are they human? Are they human skeletons?
Sure. Do go ahead and investigate.
Investigation. Pow.
Oh.
You do understand that they are skeletons, but that's about it.
This is a skeleton, my friends. And the best one I have ever seen.
How many skeletons have you seen before?
Of course, I haven't seen your skeleton, so I have no basis for comparison.
Well, I aim to make sure that no one ever sees it.
Nightmare just slowly backs away.
I walk up to him and show him my quarterstaff, and I ask, do you have anything stronger than this? Anything a bit more durable?
Oh, my goodness, this is a pretty nice-looking quarterstaff, miss. I'm afraid that anything I have would probably just slow you down.
Oh, well, I'm glad it has your approval. I have much more confidence now. Thank you.
Can I help anyone else?
I do use a crossbow from time to time, not often, but I'm wondering if you have, like, any interesting crossbow bolts that might help it out, or any crossbows that might be better than this one.
He takes a look at your crossbow and says, well, any crossbow I have is gonna be about similar to this. I do have crossbow bolts, but nothing particularly special.
I'll happily take them.
Sure. Let me check. He goes into the back room and he comes back out with 30 crossbow bolts. Here, they're all yours.
Thank you, sir.
Does anybody else need anything?
No.
There's nothing else I could possibly take from you.
Do you have any immediate needs, sir? Is your you feeling safe here?
Boy, safe is a relative term, but no, I'll be as okay as I can be.
All right. Well, we should probably get moving, hey? Our window is narrow.
Yes, please. He hops over the counter to Thought again, and he holds out his arm to Thought, and in Orcish, he says, bring them back, son. It kills me to admit, but I know I'd slow you down these days. Bring them back, and I'll owe you my life, as well as much ale as you can fit in your body.
I take his hand and say back to him in Orcish.
May the silver flame protect you, and may it protect me on this journey. And, well, if I don't come back, just know that I did everything I could to bring them with me.
You see him raise an eyebrow and cock his head slightly in confusion. But he says nothing, and he gives you another big smack on the shoulder before going back behind the counter. Thank you all.
Farewell.
All right, so where are you guys going now?
Out the door.
Okay, but that's all the map that I have prepared. So where are you going now?
I don't know.
So you're just standing out in the street in front of this shop.
Continue to one of the houses that we were directed to.
Okay. Is that where you guys want to go?
I'm fine with that. At some point, I think it might be worthwhile heading back to that tavern where it all went down. Just in case there are any leftover effects.
Yes, gather some information.
Let's do that on our way out.
Okay. So where are you going now? The house? One of the houses?
Yeah, it's one of those houses, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So just pretend you're in one of those houses. You make your way to the houses that Yen-Ben mentioned. And let's see. So the house is locked, first of all. What do you do about that?
Let's see.
Oh man.
Who went to open the door?
Nobody has lockpicks, that's the problem.
I smashed the lock.
What?
Yeah. Get it.
Okay. Smash that'll do.
Shit.
Is that really necessary? Somebody could live here.
I'll fix it later.
You'll fix it. You'll personally come back here and fix the lock.
I'll fix it later. Does it open?
Yeah, this is a flimsy wooden door. The lock just kind of pops out of the door.
Okay. Then I give Thought a really nasty look and I cast this.
What?
Okay, the lock just kind of zoops back into the door.
After I open it.
Yeah.
Apologies. Didn't know you could do that.
All is forgiven.
All right, so then you go back into this house with a perfectly functional front door that is now unlocked.
Hello? Anybody home?
There is no answer.
Well then, I'm going to look around for potions.
I'm going to roll for perception.
Can I just roll a general perception?
Yep. To all three of those.
Can I roll a constitution check for no reason?
Yes?
I'm kidding. That's a joke.
No, you can do it.
I'm not going to, though. That's a joke.
Okay. Oh, if you're, Mitch, if you're looking for potions, you can do an investigation.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I'll help him so he can roll with advantage.
Ooh.
Oh, okay, well, go ahead.
I'll just roll again.
Yep. Yeah. Okay.
A little better.
So, let's see. People who are looking, just kind of looking around the house, you can see that it's just kind of left as is. It seems as though no one was actually home at the time of the attack, as the front door remained locked. Things are just sort of existent as they were before everything happened. And let's see. So Whitmore and Lena are looking for potions. In sort of a back room that connects to the kitchen, you find a small chest, and inside of it is one potion of healing.
All right.
Do you want to take it, or should I take it?
You should take it, because I already have one.
Okay.
As well as 23 silver is in that little chest.
I'm going to leave the silver.
Okay.
Hey, Dan, do you have...
Yeah.
Do I have to add that sword manually?
Wait, there's money?
Oh, no, you do not. Hold on a second. Well, they didn't tell you about
it. You're not there to see it, yeah. So I'm just leaving it in the chest.
You are the worst dang cleric. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, seriously. Taking all the bones everywhere for no reason.
I have a gambling habit none of you know about that I have to support.
To be fair, ever since you've switched your domain, your actions have made a lot more sense.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Yeah, that's fine.
That is true, yeah.
Let's see. So, all right. So everybody, you have to, that's right. I didn't mention that the Sword of 100 Horses, in essence, is a long sword plus one. So you can search for longsword plus one and drag that into your sheet.
Plus one longsword.
How do I...
Wait, you don't have a special entry for it or anything?
I do. But
I was like,
okay.
Oh. I wanted it to like make him run around the room.
If he had done worse on his constitution check, it would have. So if you all check your journals, you can see the Sword of 100 Horses.
Damn.
Oh, sick. That's pretty cool. I love the image. That is.
Thank you.
Really cool.
I worked really hard on it. I crafted this from scratch. I just want you to know.
Hey, Martin. You got 100 HP at level 2, just like you wanted.
What? Did I say that?
Yeah, you wanted 100 HP.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, you got 100 horsepower, man.
Yep. And Sean specifically mentioned horsepower. So.
Is that how this came to be?
That is exactly how this came to be.
Damn it. I gotta keep my mouth shut.
Oh, that's so good.
Oh. I type my name
speaking all the time.
No one talks at all anymore for fear of getting a magical item.
I mean, keep talking, man.
Yes.
If you're having trouble putting that in here, hold on a second.
How do I find this? Where do you guys see it?
Hold on. Let me take care of this for you.
Lena's going to leave the money behind, but she's not going to question if anyone
else
takes it.
Never mind. I don't know why I was looking.
I just put it in there. You got it now, V.
Dan, how do we whisper again, just so I remember?
/W and then space and start typing somebody's name. Not a character name, but like the name that shows up at the bottom of the screen there.
If you're doing it correctly, it will autofill. Like, it'll suggest names.
Yeah. Lena gives...
I forgot I don't have to type my name when I do the emotes or whatever.
All right, there we go. Cool.
Oh, good. I'm glad you're renaming it.
Oh, yeah. I'm putting that in here. There's no way I'm leaving that out.
Martin, did you see the image, though? Did you see the image?
I'm looking at it right now.
Okay.
So good.
Good. I spent about, like, an hour on that.
Oh, my God.
I'm very proud of you.
That's so good.
Had to give him the majestic glow and everything.
So Sean's been paying attention to the games, huh?
Has he? I don't know.
Oh. Well, you said he suggested
HP, right? In the email. An email forever ago, you asked, I told you to let me know if you had any questions, and you said, how do I get 100 HP at level 2? and Sean said, what, 100 horsepower? And that's where it all came.
Well, now I got it. Damn it.
Yeah. You got it. All right, so here we are. Are you doing anything else in that house?
I'm gonna step outside.
I'm gonna look around for anything else. Like, is there anything in particular that I'm like looking for unique things, or like just something that I'd be drawn to? If there's anything I can tell is like emanating magical power or whatever.
No, nothing special like that. You see some, you see some objects that seem to be like family heirlooms, but like not particularly valuable family heirlooms, just something of importance to whoever once lived here.
All right.
You find some bread.
I'll take that.
Yeah, you find two loaves of bread.
Ooh, two loaves. I take those and put those in the bag of holding.
Okay. Where are you heading now?
Did we go to the tavern now then?
Wasn't there one more house to look at?
Yes.
All right, well, let's go in the other one then.
All right, so you make your way to the other house. This one, you do not need to break the lock because the door is off its hinges.
Doesn't matter, I can fix it.
Okay, so you go inside the house. What do you do there?
No. Can I investigate for anything valuable?
Sure.
I'm sorry, I don't know why I did that.
So you're looking around the house, but this place is pretty trashed. It's hard to really find anything really valuable in it.
Okay.
Anybody else?
Yeah, I'll check for potions and other supplies along that line. Okay. Whitmore, do you want to help me?
Sure.
Okay, I'll take this one.
Okay, so you are sifting through the rubble. Maybe you have a decent idea of, you know, where in this house something valuable would have been. And again, in this sort of just kind of a little storage nook, you are able to find another small chest that's actually exactly the same as the last one that you found under the rubble. And inside, again, is one single healing potion and a handful of silver. Let's say 28 to be exact.
Remy, did you take that? Like, out of character, did you take that other silver?
No, she didn't know about it.
No, I didn't. It feels only slightly wrong taking it from people who might come back.
So they did. Yenben mentioned specifically these two houses are people who are not coming back.
She still feels bad.
Well, that's good. That's the correct way to feel.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Hey, what's correct or not depends on your alignment.
Yes,
all right?
I know. I'm joking.
Pretty chaotic good, so could go either way.
Okay.
Yeah, Wimmore, you want this potion? I'm actually holding two.
Does anyone else need a potion in the group?
I'll probably be the one drinking it, but someone else will be putting it in my mouth, I bet.
That's what she said.
Oh, come on, guys.
Everyone is very strangely lighthearted for this situation. No, it's good, it's good.
You all know I'm an acolyte, right?
A what?
An acolyte of the Silver Flame.
Should give it...
You know, a holy man...
I don't understand those words coming out of your mouth right now, sir.
DM note, no, you never mentioned this to them, really. Oh. Not really.
You are a man with several holes, that's probably true.
You guys are good. So anyway.
Anyway.
You should take it. Even if we just know that it's on your body, we can still administer it to you.
That's true. All right, I'll take it.
All right, anything else in this house?
I'm guessing, like, nothing that seems magical or nothing unique or anything like that.
Again, just basically the same stuff as last time. Harder to find this time, but, you know, some knickknacks, family heirlooms, nothing magical that you can tell anyway.
So that was a potion of healing?
Yes.
So if I click on the arrow, it'll just give it to me?
Click on the arrow
in the search thing. Like I'm trying to add it to my inventory.
Oh, I just type in potion of healing for that.
Oh. Okay.
And you can drag it into your character sheet as well.
Okay, that'll be probably better. Unless it doesn't. I'll figure it out.
Any food?
I mean, you do find some food, but it is underneath, you know, broken chairs, underneath rubble, things like that, so it's not really edible anymore.
All right.
So what you doing?
Are you guys ready to go?
I'm ready to go.
Yeah.
I think we've cleared this place out the best we can.
I'm ready.
All right. Should we go to the tavern? Find out what we can find out.
Okay. So then you guys leave the house and make your way to the tavern. Let's see. I was doing some emergency cleanup while you guys were in the houses.
That's right. You said Perrin had a few things that didn't need to be used anymore. Do you think they're on his person? Or
he explained that they were probably in his cart, which is parked outside the tavern.
Okay. So before we go in, I'm going to go look for those, actually.
Okay. You can find that cart, again, just parked right outside the tavern. It's just got some boxes, and it's covered with a tarp.
All right, I'd like to start checking it out. Can I roll for that?
Do it. Yep. That'll do it. Where is that? I wrote this down. Where the hell is it?
Excuse me.
How dare you?
What happened? Okay, apparently it's gone now, so... Shit. What was I gonna do? I had this all written down. Where the fuck is it? Alright, so you dig around in that cart. Mostly you just find some like basic living stuff. He sells furniture too, apparently. You didn't know that. He's got like some chairs in there. Basically anything that he can get his hands on for cheap, he's selling. But the only useful stuff he's got... you can see that he does have another two potions of healing in one of those boxes, as well as a vaguely nondescript metal rod.
Ooh.
Okay. Does anybody?
I'll check out the metal rod.
All right.
Are you guys with me, or did you guys go in?
I didn't say I was, so.
I'm just hanging out.
I'm going to investigate that metal rod, too.
Okay, so both Nefmir and...
Actually, I'm going to do an Arcana check.
Yeah, I
want
to check it out.
You're going to do an Arcana check. Okay, so... Let's see.
Does he have any money in the thing?
I guess I'll assist Nefmir.
Okay. So one thing at a time here. I'll just do the money real quick. There's no money in the cart. He had all of his money on his person. And you don't know where his person is because Yenben has already taken him.
Did he have any food?
In the cart? No.
Yeah. Okay. But I'm uninterested.
Okay. Let's see. So, Nefmir is checking, doing an Arcana check on the rod. You can feel that it's magical, but you do not understand what kind of magic it is.
Is there anything on it, like buttons or...
Yes, there is a single button on this rod.
DM Mitch knows what this is, but...
I think I know what this is, too.
I'm going to click the button.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
How are you holding this?
I'm just holding it out in front of me and clicking the button.
Okay. You click the button, and you don't notice anything immediately.
Oh.
What do you do?
I'm going to try and pull it towards me and be like, oh, that was dumb. It didn't work.
Oh, it doesn't move.
Oh, Oh, shit.
So this rod, after he pushes the button, it remains fixed in place in midair, and will not budge even when he pulls on it.
Yeah, I'm like trying to wrench it, like trying to move it around, just like. I'm not very strong either, so
it's not moving.
I go over.
It's not moving at all.
That's.
I go over and help him.
That's interesting.
So now both of you are pulling on the rod.
Yeah.
It's not moving. It's hanging in midair, not budging an inch.
Like a single bead of sweat goes down my forehead, and then I'll let go, put my hands behind my back, and just look over and say, "It's stuck," and I'll walk away.
All right.
On second thought, I want that. And then I go up and click the button again.
You click the button and it falls into your hand. Like the weight falls into your hand, I should say.
Any objections?
Go for it.
All right.
I'm going to assume that like you're going to spend your next long rest or whatever taking a good look at that thing. So I'm going to add that to everyone's journals.
The immovable rod.
Yes, it is the immovable rod.
Sorry, you said you had two potions.
Really? Yep. So it's a flat iron rod with a button on one end. You use an action to press the button, and the rod becomes magically fixed in place. Until you or another creature uses an action to push the button again, the rod doesn't move, even if it is defying gravity. The rod can hold up to 8,000 pounds of weight.
Yeah, it's absurd. I love this item.
It's really good for, like, interesting strategies.
Yeah, it's... Yeah. Yep.
It sounds interesting.
How big is it?
All right.
It's like a foot or two or something like that.
It's a foot.
Huh. How thick is it?
I'm thick
with two C's.
Roller quarters?
No, yeah. not thick with two C's, no.
Martin hears roll of quarters and his ears perk up. So that's what you find in the cart.
That was a serious question. I just added a jokey tone to it. I really want to know how
it's like a roll of quarters.
Really?
Yeah, it's something like that. Yeah, okay, it's like a regular metal bar. Yeah. You can fit it in your hand.
All right.
Easily.
You can fit a lot of things in your hand.
Let's say it's an inch in diameter.
Okay.
I'll put those two potions of healing in my inventory, unless someone wants one.
No objection.
Yes. Yeah. Go ahead and take one.
Thank you.
I'll take the other one then.
Boy, you guys are just loaded with potions now.
Now I have one.
All right. Where to, what do?
Go in the tavern then?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, you guys are in the tavern. As you go in, you can see there are a few survivors that are sort of just sitting quietly and shaken in the tavern. The bartender is also still there, very quiet. He's just kind of wiping the same dish over and over again. He doesn't really seem to have, you know, a reason to be doing it. And as soon as you come in, you'll notice on the right side, there's a stack of skeletons that you defeated next to the door. And on the other side of the room, there is a very unique-looking tiefling who's just kind of hanging out, sitting on the table over there.
He's sitting on the table?
He's sitting on the table.
Ah.
Like butt on table, legs on floor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, he's got long legs then.
I guess so.
I don't know about you, but when I sit on a table, my feet don't touch the ground.
It's a pretty low table, but whatever. All right.
It's kind of pull up a chair and just sit down and be like, what's up, my teeth?
Is this some sort of like, is it like how we don't understand like certain parts of like black culture, and they're just like, what's up, my teeth? Is that something that you guys just say to each other?
Yes, that we're just, that is something
we don't understand that
very awkwardly and uncomfortably trying to. Yes.
Upon your greeting, the tiefling looks at you and says, oh, hail and well met, travelers.
Yes.
Oh no.
I'm sorry, what did he say?
I'm just
hail and well met, travelers.
No, I said that because I'm so far away, but he shouted loud that I heard it. And I'm just like, what?
And he doesn't understand that you're being sarcastic, so he shouts at you
louder. Oh, he heard that all the way over there.
Oh, hail and well met, travelers!
I heard you. I'm sorry. That was supposed to be a whisper.
You're pretty amped for this this fairly somber situation. Is the drink that good? I mean, it was. I had some last night.
Oh, but the drink is good. Life is good because I'm alive, my friends.
That's fair.
I'm kind of feeling you. You see, we're alive as well.
Are you feeling him literally?
Do you want to? I have noticed that you're alive.
Do you want to touch his skeleton?
Please don't touch my skeleton.
Nobody said that. He doesn't know. Nobody said that.
Oh, he knows.
How does he know? Thought didn't say that. All right. All right. I'm gonna go up to him now.
Were you around last night?
Oh, I was. I witnessed your very valorous fighting last night.
Oh, you saw us. I'm even more embarrassed then.
Well, it may not have gone well, but you were brave. That's something.
I suppose.
The drink tends to help with the braveness. Bartender, and I'm going to go up and ask for a breakfast ale.
An oatmeal stout.
The bartender just kind of looks at you, like, sort of blankly, and doesn't say anything. He just fills up a mug and gives it to you.
This doesn't feel good. Sir?
The tiefling continues talking to Thought and Nefmir. Like, so, travelers, may I ask your names?
Whitmore Evanwood, at your service.
From all
That's
the way
a
over
good
there.
Name!
Yes, hello, my name is Thought.
Thought? That's a good name!
Maybe.
I've never heard it before. I like it.
Yes, it's orcish in origin.
I like orcish.
You know it?
Oh, I do.
Are you a scholar of some type?
You could say that.
Okay. So,
Oh, I'm being very rude. You may call me Timmy Tim. Magic boy Timmy Tim. I'm somewhat of a purveyor of magical goods.
I don't like him. He looks too eager. I wanted to insight check him to see if he's full of, if he's hiding something.
I'm checking him.
Okay, go ahead.
I had to turn around because I was laughing too much.
So, Nefmir doesn't get a good grip on this guy, but everyone else an incredibly good grip on this guy. You understand that he's not, like, ill-meaning or anything like that. He's not telling, you know, like, the complete truth about himself, but he is earnest in his words. Okay. And Thought has no idea.
He's not telling the truth about himself, but he's earnest? What does that even mean?
He is not telling the whole truth, but his his basic conversation so far has been earnest.
Would you say that they can tell that he's well-meaning?
Yeah.
In other words, his name is not actually Timmy Tim.
Perhaps.
On that note,
is he telling the truth about having magical goods?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, that's a name I've never heard before. Was that your given name, or is that sort of a title you've taken on?
He grins, like, impossibly wide, showing his big, sharp, tiefling teeth, and says, "Oh, you'll never know."
Okay. So, do you make these goods, or do you find them, or?
Oh, I do create magical items now and then, but I don't sell them. Instead, I use my greatest invention to sell you the chance to chase your dreams. I sell luck embodied. I sell the ability to obtain magic beyond your wildest dreams for coppers on the gold piece. Not literal copper, of course. That would be ridiculous.
Well, that is very vague.
Okay. So here's how it works. You pay me 40 gold pieces and you get to touch my box.
Oh, wow. Fuck. It's a gacha system.
That is a ton of gold. We just touch a box? I mean...
So, my box is very special, and what is inside the box depends entirely on fate. I guarantee it is a magical item, but its effectiveness may vary.
Remy.
However, I know nothing of what will be produced, but there is one exception. There is as equal a chance as any that the box may produce a magical token. With such an outcome, you win my personal magical item.
Remy, you like gambling, right?
Don't encourage her.
Remy, I don't want to do it, but I want to see how it works.
I definitely don't want to see how it works. Things in
there. All of you don't know I have a gambling problem yet.
Oh, fuck, sorry. That's right, you didn't say it out loud.
I did.
The bartender gives Remy brunch.
Awesome.
Does Remy seem intrigued by this conversation?
No.
He's typing.
Now, it is, if perhaps you find yourself a bit short on money, I could consider a first-time sale. Maybe not 40 gold, perhaps 20.
I'm going to take my brunch and move a little closer, but I'm not really going to engage in this.
Magical boy Timmy Tim? Was that it?
Timmy Tim!
Magical boy Timmy Tim. Yes. Have you lived in this town for long, or?
Oh, goodness, no. I travel.
Yeah, I see.
I'm a traveling salesman.
Traveling salesman with a magic box that randomly spits out something.
Yes. Would you like to see? Would you like to touch my box, young half-orc?
No, please. I don't want to touch your box. I've had enough magic for one day. I touched a sword and it made me whinny like a horse. I need to take some rest from the arcane.
Lena hands him 20 gold but doesn't make eye contact.
Oh, look at this cute little shy one. Okay, she wants to touch my box. Wonderful!
Please stop talking. I don't like those words coming out of your mouth.
He looks slightly offended and says, "My words are all that I have sometimes. You understand." He holds out his box toward you.
And I touch it.
Roll a d20. Okay. The box glows very mysteriously. And you hear a slight click as the it sounds like a lock seems to have unlocked. Timmy Tim reaches over, sort of like wrapping his fingers very delicately around the top of the box, and opens it up. And inside, you can see a glass vial with, it seems like, a black liquid inside.
Oh.
So if you don't take it, Timmy Tim takes it out of the box very delicately and says, "Ooh, this is a good one. Here you are, my lady."
All right, I take it. Can I tell what it is by looking at it?
No.
Okay. Can you explain? Would you like
to... Yeah, you can ask.
Yeah. Can you explain to me what this is, please? I've never seen this before.
Oh, my good lady, that is the Oil of Shadows.
Oil of Shadows?
Yes. You might even say that this inky oil can cover a medium or smaller creature and takes 10 minutes to apply. The affected creature loses any sunlight sensitivity it may possess and any vulnerability to radiant damage.
Oh.
This guy's guys, like an encyclopedia. I would like to take a bathroom break if I can.
Oh.
Okay.
I mean, this is a fine place to do it.
But I can't hold it any longer.
All right, very interesting. Thank you. I'll put it in my inventory.
Oh, it's not done yet.
Oh, it's not? Oh, okay.
In addition to that, you do gain advantage on any stealth checks that you might make.
Oh, okay.
Ooh. Seems kind of gross.
Oh, it is.
Oh my god.
Imagine you have to rub this shit on your skin for 10 minutes. It's disgusting. Would anyone else like to touch my box after Ben comes back from the bathroom? Bathroom break.
Hey yo.
Is everybody back?
Yeah, but my internet's being weird.
I can't hear what Ben's saying.
Yeah, I can't hear what anyone's saying because everybody's robotic.
I don't hear robots at all.
Martin,
everyone sounds fine.
Okay. Okay.
All right, are everybody ready to rumble?
Yeah.
Okay. Lena has her potion of her Oil of Shadows. And Timmy Tim looks very pleased with this customer and turns to everyone else. Would anybody else like to touch my box today?
Do you touch your own box?
Oh, all the time. Very frequently, in fact.
Well, what do you do with all the stuff that it makes?
Well, I tend to sell it to merchants.
Make that box quite valuable then, I imagine.
Oh, it must be. But to me, it is literally priceless because there is no price that I would ever accept for it. And in fact, I would defend it with my very life.
I'm sure you would. Oh, don't worry. I don't want anything to do with it. I'm just asking.
Oh, you don't want to touch my box?
I certainly do not, no.
So does Remy say that? Does Remy say Remy is now interested?
Yes.
Maybe just her facial expression?
Shook her head. No, oh, okay. She shook her head yes to... She literally said Remy is now interested.
I can't see the video from most people because my screen is full. So let me know if you're doing something physical.
She shook her head yes to saying literally Remy is now interested.
Timmy Tim turns toward Remy and sort of perks up. Ooh, I like the way that you refer to yourself. Money, please.
No. I'm good for now.
Oh, that's right, Lena. Don't forget to take 20 gold out.
I already did.
Okay. So no one else wants to touch my box? There's better stuff in there.
So it's 20 for the first time and 40 after that?
Yes.
Lena hands him 40 gold.
Damn.
Not making eye contact.
Wow. Oh, a repeat customer in the same day. My goodness. Someone likes to touch my box.
She doesn't say anything. She just touches it.
All right. D20. Oh, okay. Okay. The box clicks, and Timmy Tim opens it up, and inside there is a ring.
I take the ring.
Okay. Let's see. He says, ooh, that's the glamored ring. Perfect for a beautiful lady such as yourself. While wearing this ring, you can use a bonus action to speak its command word, which is ring time, by the way, and cause it to assume the appearance of some other ring. You can decide what it looks like, including the color and the style and anything you'd like. The illusory appearance lasts until you use this property again or remove the ring.
Wow.
Okay. Thank you.
You don't seem very pleased with this one, lady.
It's purely cosmetic, right?
Oh, it sure is.
Yeah. We're gonna go fight a bunch of stuff, so I was hoping...
Oh, you don't want to...
You're gonna go fight a bunch of stuff, you say?
Yeah.
You don't want to, in the middle of battle, say ring time and change what color your ring is.
Well, in that case, because you are my first repeat customer ever, I will give you the option to sell that back to me for 35 gold.
Oh. Okay, sure.
Wait, no. I'll buy it from you. 40 gold.
Oh, okay.
If it's shiny and pretty, I want it.
Okay. I give it to her.
Okay, so there you go. You can add that to your inventory then.
Just a useless ring.
Yep.
Well,
be
it has
sure
a
to
use
it frequently.
The use is that it changes.
So just like a, you know, side note here, there is actually good stuff in this. You guys are just not having very good luck at the moment. There's plenty of good stuff, actually.
I take the 40 gold from her and I hand it to him again.
Oh my god.
Oh, three times in one day. You're my new favorite customer. And he takes 5 gold and hands it back to you and says, because you're so pretty.
Oh, thank you.
Roll a d20.
Wait, he said that? He said roll a d20.
All right. Oh, here you go. See, the lock clicks. He opens the box, and inside is a monocle.
All right, I take that.
He says, "Ooh, very, very scholarly of you. Please try it on."
Okay, I do so.
You feel smarter.
Oh.
He says, "That is the scholar's monocle. I just made up that name. All of these names, by the way, I'm making them up on the spot."
How do you even know what they do? This...
Magic! Oh. Magic!
Dastardly magic.
While wearing this crystal lens in a library or similar setting, you have an advantage on intelligence, which are investigation checks, to find relevant books and information.
Oh, all right. Cool. Thank you.
There are no libraries on this island!
What? Wait, are you serious?
No, I'm not serious. There are two big cities. I'm sure they have a library. I've just never checked.
Or similar settings, huh?
Or similar settings!
Okay.
Oh my god.
So maybe like a records place or...
Yeah.
Something like that. All right. Cool.
Wondrous item.
Wondrous. Now, seeing this lady's wonderful magic, would anyone else like to touch my box?
You guys, if it's only 20 for your first time, it might be worth it.
I'm not actually even holding any gold, but my character is vehemently opposed to touching this box.
You should be. I mean, you've got the money from Perrin.
Oh.
Did you not add 50 gold?
I guess I didn't, because...
You should add 50 zero. Gold if all you right. haven't already. If
oh, we all got 50 gold?
Yeah. He went around the tavern and he gave everyone 50 gold.
Yeah, he did. I guess yeah. I just didn't add that.
Oh, yes. I added that.
Well, yep. I have 30 now because I touched the box.
Oh, you touched the box. Okay. All right.
Nethmir has
touched the box. Roll the d20. My tiefling friend, I hope you get what's coming to you.
I don't like the sound of that.
Where's just the... Just
on the left side, the dice button on that left toolbar. Okay. Ooh, well, this is rather appropriate. The box clicks, he opens it up, and inside is a scroll. Would you like him to explain it, or would you like to read it?
I'll go ahead and read it.
Okay. Then I will just copy this over to you, and you can decide what to do with it. Timmy Tim grins widely and hands the scroll over.
I guess I'll touch the box.
Okay.
Do you have enough money for that?
Do you want to tell them about the zombie scroll?
Well, now we know what it is.
Well, I was going to, but I'm definitely going to now.
Yeah, thank you.
So, fellow travelers, the scroll appears to have been stitched together from various skins and hides. And it looks like I can just use it on any dead creature with zero hit points. It becomes stable and is animated as an undead zombie.
Oh,
it follows my mm-hmm. it follows my mental commands.
Well, that's gruesome. Please don't use it on me.
You know, if push comes to shove, but I'll try my best not to, I thought.
Please let it not be so.
Okay, and Remy's touching the box?
Yeah.
Alright, so do you have 20 gold?
I do. I was also hoarding a bunch of money from before.
Okay.
So yes, I should have 40 somewhere in there.
Okay.
Or 20, because I already spent 40.
Yeah.
Right.
So what do I
do? If you it put says that... you have 15 gold pieces.
Yeah, I haven't been writing it in there.
Oh,
what you should. Yeah, you should do that.
There's also copper pieces that we found when we played on the 17th.
Oh, those are. And didn't there's... you guys put those in the bag of holding?
Yeah, that's what I thought.
We did.
I mean, do you want some bag of holding money?
No, I think I have 40 gold that I took from someone.
Oh, y'all, we have hella money in here.
Yeah. Well. I feel entitled to use it because I found it. Well, that sucked.
Did it?
It doesn't necessarily suck. But perhaps. So you you touch the box, it glows, the lock clicks. Timmy Tim opens the box and inside is another potion. He picks it up tenderly and says, "Oh, I do so like this one." This is the potion of vocal glamour, very much like that ring that you have. It is purely cosmetic. After drinking this churning potion, you can alter your voice to sound like ringing bells for 1 minute.
That could actually be useful.
All right.
You turn into a church.
What?
Congratulations, I like that potion.
Have you used that one before?
Very often, when I'm alone.
Alright. I'll put down my tankard and walk over and pay him.
Does it,
My box is becoming very popular now!
Does it sound anything like this? And I cast that liturgy of ringing bells on the box.
Well, you can choose whatever bells you want it to sound like, so.
Church bells. The holiest of bells.
The holiest of
bells. I mean, like, the potion. The potion as well. So, yes, it's literally the same thing. You can do either one. Okay, so Whitmore puts down 20 gold?
Yep.
Oh, goodness, I'm eating well today! Roll the d20. I believe, did someone already roll that one? Nope, okay. Okay, you touch the box, it glows, the lock clicks, and inside is another potion.
Oh,
he takes it out, it's very dark. And he looks into it, and as he hands it to you, he says, "Ooh, this, my good friend, is the elixir of death. When you drink this shadowy potion, you fall into a cataleptic state as if you had just cast the spell Feign Death on yourself."
Just what I needed.
The effect lasts for 1d20 minutes.
Why does this guy keep saying D and then a number?
You'll never know.
Sir. Well, thank you, good sir.
Oh, you are very welcome. Let me know anytime you'd like to touch my box.
Are you just going to keep hanging out here, Timmy Tim?
Oh, I'll move on eventually.
I've got a feeling this is not the last time we're going to meet this guy, guys.
No! I'm going to follow you!
Please don't.
I've got a very
You are by far my best customers!
Are we your only customers, Timmy Tim?
Yes!
Well, what on earth were you doing before you came here, then?
He said he was selling magical items.
Merchants!
Well, but if we're your only customers, then... did you sell anything to anybody?
Not much, but you're the only ones who have touched my box personally.
Oh, I see.
We're very close now.
Well, not you and I. I haven't touched it.
Would you like to?
No, no.
For you, I would even make it 15.
Please don't put that box anywhere near me.
Please touch my box.
I will not, no.
Say, didn't you say you were going to go fight people?
Yes.
Yes, which we're doing right now, isn't it, Thought?
Yes, we are going to leave right now, and we're not going to come back here.
Okay! Good luck, don't die! I hope you spend more time on my box later!
Oh, God.
I wave at him a little bit, like, hesitantly on the way out.
I love you!
My character hates this guy.
Yummy likes him.
I love this guy, but Thought hates him.
All right, you guys are leaving?
All right. Yeah,
that's what I'm doing.
Yeah.
If you turn to look back, you'll see him waving happily because he loves you.
Oh. I turn around to look at him and just give him a small wave.
He waves harder.
He waves harder.
Yes.
I hope we see you again.
Oh, you will. I'll be seeing you. So, where are you going?
I like him. I like him. We should keep him around.
Good.
He makes Thought uncomfortable too. He's interesting.
Certainly is.
So we're gonna take that card and head out. We don't have to check back in with the cleric before we leave.
I finally found Perrin's shit that I wrote down. My goodness. Anyway.
Well, we should go to that stable, right?
Yeah, you should. Are you going to the stable?
Yeah.
Sure.
Okay, at the stables, you find... So you make your way through the town, following the directions. And I believe you find... 3 horses still attached to the stable. The fence to the stable has been broken down, very likely by a very scared horse. Any other horses that were in the stable have long since escaped. They are nowhere in sight, but 3 of them are still attached. They're still roped up to the stable.
Any one of us good at riding these things?
I am certainly not good at animal handling.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's animal handling, by the way.
Are any of you rangers?
I'm good with just walking on.
None of us are rangers.
Nope.
As you're discussing the horses, actually, Cleric Yenben comes running up out of breath. Thank Paylor. I've caught you before you left. I'm going with you.
What?
I had decided to leave my adventuring days behind me, and I may just hold you back, but Paylor helped me. I have to try. These are my people, and they need me. Please, let me join you.
I don't think we're going to say no, but... You sure about
he
this?
He saved our lives, so please.
Thank you.
Please come with us.
I am fairly handy on a horse, so whoever rides with me, you'll have a pretty good ride.
I'm riding with you.
Okay. So do you guys, he's getting very informal. Hey, y'all see any horses? No. So did you find any other horses? Are these the only horses left?
We found horses.
This is the only ones we've seen.
Okay. Well,
again, we haven't looked that hard.
Well, fortunately, we should be able to manage with 2 to a horse.
I've never ridden a horse before.
I thought we were gonna take Perrin's cart.
If you take the cart, you won't make good time at all.
That makes sense.
It's a good thing I came. You're gonna take the cart?
That's yet to be seen.
Why would you take the cart?
I didn't say anything.
Because we're
about
not
that.
Good at horses.
Yeah.
I just misunderstood. I'm sorry.
Who's gonna roll animal handling?
He's gonna roll animal handling, but you guys can decide whoever's gonna ride. Whoever is taking charge of the horse, roll an animal handling check.
Does anybody
have more than one?
I'm one.
I'm also one.
I'm riding with Yenben.
Mitch?
I have +2 to handling.
Ooh, alright.
Okay,
well, you're rolling.
As do I. I'll roll. Why not?
Okay.
Cleric Yenben mounts the nearest horse like a breeze. No issue whatsoever. Whitmore also mounts this horse with very, with skill. It's a good mount. And Nefmir goes to climb up the horse. And he seems to have misplaced his footing, and he stumbles a little bit. He kind of struggles to get his leg over the top, but eventually he does. So who is riding with who?
I'll get on Nefmir's horse.
And I'll get on Whitmore's horse.
All right,
so we've got... Hold on a second.
Don't worry, I have no idea what I'm doing.
That's not very comforting.
Well, you sure got on that thing convincingly.
Beginner's luck, really.
Okay. Well, at least you're straightforward about it.
Let's see. So, are you ready to go?
Yeah, we're ready to head out, aren't we? Aren't we?
Okay.
Looks like we're ready.
All right, so where are you going?
Wherever the wind takes us.
To the forest, right?
There's a forest all around you.
Do we want to go to the ranger station where we found that weird sigil on the ground?
That's probably a good start.
I thought we were going to head straight to the other one that we haven't been to.
The Far
East. Well, that's a good idea.
To find the reinforcements that we...
Yenben speaks up. Fortunately, they are both on the same road. I would not think that he would simply return to the same place he was, but we may as well check it out along the way.
All right.
Okay, so you guys are setting off.
Yep.
Yes.
All right, so you start cruising. You're heading along the road. You're making very good time on these horses, except for Nefmir and Thought. You're not doing so great. The Nefmir is having a hard time controlling this majestic animal. He's, you know, maybe it's still a little bit spooked from, you know, the events of the night before, but he's kind of straining against the reins. He's not really following the commands very well, but you know, you're getting there. You're moving faster than you would if you had been walking.
Can I take the sword out of its sheath and place it flat on the horse?
Yeah. I was just going to ask if you could have advantage on animal handling with horses.
Oh, yes. No, not... yes, absolutely. Go ahead and roll animal handling again, Nefmir. Hello?
Man.
Ben?
Uh-oh.
What happened to Ben?
Ben died. Ben,
well,
don't
Ben
die.
Is dying. I'm going to go to the bathroom. I What's actually up? Never got up before.
Oh, there you are. Did you not hear us, Ben?
I died. I'm sorry.
What happened?
I'm not sure. No, I'm just kidding.
Okay.
I just didn't go to the bathroom.
Okay. Martin suggested that perhaps laying the sword of 100 horses would there's a gnat in this room. Oh, I got it. Nice. He said that perhaps laying the horse sword on the horse would help, and it will. So go ahead and roll animal handling again.
All right. I'm going to try that one more time so we can get a horse on.
Yeah, that's better. Good. So Fought unsheathes this sword, and as he does, he rolls a constitution save.
Oh, a save.
Save.
Okay. I'm better at that. No, I'm not.
And he whinnies loudly.
Magic.
And he places it against the side of the horse, and in turn, the horse sort of perks up and gives a grand, majestic, woo! That was really grand and majestic, by the way. Just imagine that.
Mm-hmm.
And it suddenly sort of rights itself and sort of, it seems to be sitting up straighter too. Like everything about this horse just improved. And it starts obeying commands and moving faster. So now as a group, you are moving faster. Good work. Is Kim back yet?
No.
Kim went to the bathroom when Ben wasn't answering, so I guess we'll just wait a second. That sounds like she's coming back.
Yeah, just a sec.
Are you ready?
Just a sec.
What are you doing? Hello?
Hello.
Hello.
Kim?
Hold on.
What are you doing?
Eating oat chips.
What?
Why didn't you do this during the bathroom break?
Oat chips.
I forgot to get up.
You didn't go to the bathroom, you didn't move during the bathroom break, and now you're slowing things down.
Sorry, I'm here now.
Are you here now?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, the animal handling check went better, and now the horse is good. They're moving. All right. So you guys continue down the road. Boy, you'd never even know that anything crazy went down last night. It's just some regular stuff, some regular forest. You continue on normally. Are you doing anything special?
No, I'm not.
Anybody?
I guess while Whitmore's driving, I'll keep an eye out for any enemies, goblins, okay, or whatever.
Well, that's right. Okay, let's see. So you can do investigation then.
What's investigation, not perception?
Well, you're looking specifically for something, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I was like just trying to keep aware.
Okay, then if you're just trying to like look around you, then that's perception.
Can I just kind of look around?
I don't
around?
Know why I argued for the one that I'm worse at, but okay.
Perception. I'm just going to do one too. Wow. Oh, that's bad.
And good for Lena. Okay. So as you continue on, actually, hold on a second. This music is not relevant anymore. So anyway, you are moving along. Eventually, over time, you reach the ranger station uneventfully, the abandoned ranger station. And you don't really notice anything in particular until Lena, as she's looking around you guys, you notice a large number of figures in the trees around you.
I pull on Whitmore's coat or whatever.
What is it?
There's people in the trees.
I like to imagine that you're actually eating the bread that you got before as well. Here, there's people in the trees.
No, my apple. I'm eating my apple.
Okay.
She just casually says that. Hey, there's people in the trees, guys.
People. Why don't you do a perception check then?
All right.
I guess with advantage because you're looking for something that she is telling you about.
Okay.
Yeah, you do. You see, you can't tell how many, but you can see several, like many dark figures around you in the trees.
I'm gonna just yell like, "We have company," and I'm going to pull off to the side of the road and jump off the horse.
Okay. The figures start to close in around you as you shout that out. And they are so many in number. It is a large bandit or a large mercenary company. They're literally coming out of the woodwork now. There are many, many all around you. They are on your left, on your right, and they are surrounding you from behind.
Do they look alive or undead?
They're alive. They are living mercenaries.
Well, this is wonderful.
Well, this is convenient.
Yenben shouts, "Get back on the horse!"
Shh. Seems like a good idea. I'll jump on and get going.
Okay. So
I cast magic armor on myself. Or mage armor.
Okay. What happens?
Ah, fuck. I'm finished coloring my picture.
Just explain it for now, then.
So there's a little crystal at the end of her staff, and some magic light comes out from it and forms a kind of vest. It looks like metal, but it's not actually metal. It's like way too clean and smooth. So she has a vest and an open skirt that protects her hips, boots, arm bracers, and then she pulls her veil down so she can breathe better, and she's got little, what can I say? A little bit of cheek armor as well.
Okay. So you don that magical armor.
Yeah.
And Yenben, after shouting that, he charges ahead of the group and leads the way as the bandits on foot close in behind you. Are you all running ahead?
Yeah, just kicking the horse to try and get it to go a little faster.
Okay. So, you take off.
I don't know if I signed up for this.
Yeah, you did.
And by the way, yes, Kim.
Okay.
Hold on a second while we're working something out real quick. Are you doing it?
I thought you did it.
Oh, it's right. I'm doing it. Hold on a second. Okay. Wow, that was actually really close, but nothing.
Okay.
All right. So as you tear off on these horses, the bandits on foot cannot keep up whatsoever. But five mercenaries on horses emerge from the forest and begin to chase you down. The one in front shouts out, "Don't forget, boys, he wants them alive! Anyone who can't handle that loses their cut!" And they begin to approach from behind.
As they approach, I'd like to cast a cantrip.
But you're going to have to wait on that one because we're entering initiative.
Okay, damn it.
Enter initiative. Go ahead and roll. Select your people, your tokens, and do the thing.
Great.
Ooh.
Oh, come on.
Ooh, indeed.
Hold on a second.
I saw them first. Why is my initiative terrible?
One second, please. I need to grab Yenben's stuff, but it's hiding. There it is. And he gets...
Don't make it hide.
Okay. One second. Okay. Oh, wait, I didn't roll initiative for any of these other guys. They're just going to get a big group initiative. And, okay, it's pretty high.
So they were in the trees and now they, like, jumped onto the, like, horses in the woods?
They were, so the horses were on the other side of the abandoned ranger station.
Gotcha.
They had hidden the horses behind. They were hoping to catch you inside of the building, but they were noticed first. So these horses are chasing after you, and they have rather than do all five, I'm just gonna, well, okay, hold on, just it's only fair, I'll add turns for all of them. Okay. So, on this map, the implication is that you are all moving forward at generally the same speed. So forward movement is implied unless you choose to stop. Moving backward, if you go backward, it's your full 30-foot speed, like your basic speed. But moving forward is half of that because you can't break away from your pursuers as easily.
Right. Right?
Let's see. You have double damage with ramming or piercing weapons when moving backward toward them at full speed. But if you do that, your half of your movement, your next turn, is spent turning around to continue forward.
Huh. All right.
Yoroshiku, Whitmore.
What?
No, I'm leaving.
He doesn't know Japanese.
I leave the movement to you. You do what you gotta do.
What did she say?
All right. Yoroshiku, it just means I'm leaving it to you.
Okay. Yeah, how would he know that?
Yeah, right. All right, so first up is Thought of Athrazar.
All right. I'm going to throw a javelin.
Okay.
At
which one?
Here's my thing. Ruler. Probably this one, right?
Okay.
Actually, you know what? No, I'm going to throw it at this guy.
Okie dokie.
All right. So I just click on the javelin, right?
Yeah.
All right.
All right. That's a hit.
Okay.
Okay. So you, from horseback, you hurl a javelin, and it sticks into this guy's arm, giving 4 damage.
Okay.
Right, any movement? Well, you can't move.
Yeah, so I can't move.
Moving on to Whitmore.
I would like to navigate the horse so that we stay back and get, like, parallel with this guy.
Okay, sounds good. So while you are doing animal handling, you can attack, but you're at disadvantage.
Okay. So I can either move.
You can move and attack, but if you move, your attacks are at disadvantage.
All right. I just want to lean over and try and kick the guy out of his saddle.
Okay. Go ahead and I guess just an unarmed attack. We don't have that built into your sheet. first of all, roll the attack, which is just a d20.
Do I get anything from like dex or?
Yeah, I was gonna say you can do d20 plus your dex modifier.
Okay, I'll just roll dexterity then, because that'll be basically what
okay,
that
sure.
is, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Oh yeah, we're great.
So I'm guessing you don't have a whole lot of experience fighting on horseback. So you pull up next to this guy fairly easily, but you sort of, you know, kind of reach out with your leg to kick at him, but you just kind of end up kicking his horse in the shoulder a little bit, and the horse doesn't seem to mind.
All right,
moving on. What's that?
Do I have any more movement on my horse?
How far did you move? Let's see, you moved 5.
I was like 15, here, 20. Maybe.
Yeah, you have a bit more.
I'd like to use my bonus action to disengage.
Okay.
And then just move back and up, like just away from him, like 5 feet.
Okay, sounds good. All right, next up is that dude, actually. So he's going to follow you.
Mm.
And he's going to take a swing at Whitmore. And let's see. Wait, what? Hold on a second. I have an info block for this thing, but there's no attacks on it. I think I cut it off. I'm just gonna make one up on the fly. So he pulls out his sword, or he's had his sword out, and he takes a quick slice at Whitmore, and he does 3 damage.
Oh, do I not even against my armor class, or?
Huh?
Yeah, what's the roll?
Oh, the roll was 19.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, that'll.
Yeah, he got you. So 3 damage. Yeah, 3 damage to Whitmore. All right, and next up is this guy. He's going to move up a ways, and he's going to fire an arrow at Thought. I don't need to ask. That arrow fires very wide.
Okay.
Next up is Nefmir.
How do you ping stuff again?
Click and hold.
Just click and hold it down.
Okay. I'm going to attack. I'm trying that. It's not pinging.
There it is.
That was mine. If you're,
oh, that was you.
You could use your ruler you're instead.
Fine. So I'm going to attack clicking this boy right here.
You have to have the selector tool.
Yeah,
selected.
Yeah, I realized
too.
That.
Yeah. Okay.
Fixed it.
Okay.
So again,
so you're attacking this guy. Okay.
Yep. I'm going to shoot an Eldritch Blast at him.
Okay, and that's at disadvantage.
All right.
Because you are also riding this horse, steering this horse, like you're one hand in it. So.
Yep. That's cool. I look cooler that way. Anyway.
Yeah, you do. Imagine if you pull this off.
Uh huh. And that is, and I'll also specify that is with repelling.
Oh yeah, that's
well.
Oh, good idea. That's shit. Actually a game changer here. So
I imagine that could possibly knock.
Yeah, I think
guy
it would.
Right off that horse.
I think so, it would. So go ahead and
go.
Take that shot.
Ah
no! Oh my goodness, because that first one would have really hit. Yeah, so you fire wide, and that it almost kind of singes Thought, but it goes flying very far wide. Unfortunately.
And then,
are you going to move?
No, I'm going to stay the course.
Thought, if you want to, like, request movement, you're able to do that.
Yeah, I think he will say that.
Ask the horse very politely.
Not the horse. I mean, I could try to channel my will through the sword, but I don't know if that's going to work.
Or you could just ask the guy riding the horse.
Yeah, I'm going to ask the guy on the horse.
If we get up next to this one, I might be able to swing at him a little better.
Would you like to move?
Uh-oh. Did he die again?
Ben?
Uh-oh.
Ben? Ben?
What's up?
Oh, are you still there?
Ben.
Oh, so wait. Martin and I are riding the same horse, yeah?
Yeah. So okay. He's asking you to move.
All right, where are you moving to? I forgot I was riding horse.
Yeah, you're riding the horse. I said that we should try to get next to this guy.
Sure, okay.
So, I'm not sure. We can probably make it there, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're fine. And I'll let you know, too, that if you wanted to not be within, if you wanted Thought to be in hitting range but not Nefmir, you could always move like this.
Yeah.
Do you want to do that?
I'm cool with whatever.
Okay.
I think that's a better idea. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So you move there.
Mel Horson.
Okay. All right. Next up. Next up is this dude. And he's going to, let's see. He's going to pull up right here. Well, 3 horses right in a line. He's going to fire an arrow. Oh, 10, 20, 30, 40 feet. Okay. He's going to fire an arrow at Remy. It doesn't hit. It goes flying wide again. I feel like these dudes are really bad at multitasking on horses.
It's really hard to shoot a bow on a horse.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So next up is Yenben. And he shouts back to Remy, "Where you want to go, miss?"
Away from them?
He doesn't say anything. He just starts moving backward towards them.
Right.
Let's see. Boy, what does Yenben do right now?
Yeah, I'm also wondering that.
He's actually going to... I should have given this a little bit more thought. But anyway, mm-hmm. He's going to...
I got all the thought you need right here.
I mean, you do realize, Yenben, that eventually they were going to come to us because, you know...
I'm sorry, it's been a while since I've been out on an adventure, miss.
Why would we get closer to all of them? All right. Whatever.
For this! And he casts Bless on Remy, on Thought, and on Nefmir. So, for the next minute, you three, whenever you make an attack roll or a saving throw, you can add a d4 to it, and that's good.
Cool.
Sure.
To the attack roll.
To the attack roll or to a saving throw.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Next up is this dude, and he's going to come right up to Remy.
Really?
And he's taking a swing with his sword. And that's a 16 plus 2.
No.
What you got? What's your armor class?
Armor class is 16.
He actually hit.
Do I have a shield?
You've already added that to it, though.
Okay.
Wait, she has a shield?
So that's assuming that I have it up.
Yeah, she has a shield.
Yeah, she's a shield. I thought your armor class was 18.
So, because my armor class says 16 right now, but it doesn't. Is that assuming that I have the shield?
Yeah,
up?
I think that it was because that's with the shield normally, yeah.
But okay. We both have the same armor, she and I.
Yes, but I have a shield.
But it's also based on dexterity.
Okay.
I have, no dexterity.
Huh. It's based on dex and.
Exactly.
Else,
so,
I
think it probably balances out because your dexterity is probably higher than her, but she has a shield.
Okay. Well, because I have one too. It's just that.
Oh, you do too?
Yeah, we both have chainmail and a shield, so it's. Hypothetically, we should have this. And my dex is 12.
Let me take a look real quick.
My dexterity is 0.
No, your dex is 10.
The modifier, yeah. Let's see. So.
Well, 11, it's still not that high.
Dexterity 1, dexterity 0, armor is that.
At least I don't have a negative 1 this time.
Yeah,
so that shouldn't, if you're, is your shield included in your armor class already, Martin?
I don't know. I just know that my AC is 18.
I believe it is. Yeah, because
it's hard to tell with this, so.
I believe it is, but I believe it is. We'll take a better look later, but I believe both of yours are correct.
All right.
Okay, sure.
Pretty.
So either way, it hits me.
Yeah, either way, it does hit you this time. And...
Okay.
He hits you for max damage. Look at that. He got you for 7. Off you go. He catches you good in that armor. And you take 7 slashing damage.
Okay.
And then this guy. He's also moving up. Maybe right here or so. And he's taking another... arrow shot, but he's going to shoot at Nefmir this time. And he does not hit. These arrows are flying wide. flying very wide, all over the place. It's bumpy terrain, rough stuff. Lena's turn. What you gonna do?
All right.
Bumpy.
I'm going to cast. Just a second. Sorry. Okay. Yeah. I'm going to cast this one.
This one.
The one that is this.
Wait, nope, sorry, wrong one. I'm pinging this one. Before I cast that, I grab Whitmore tightly and I say, keep me within 30 feet.
Okay,
got it.
So which one are you attacking?
Not the one right next to us, because I'm worried that it's going to spook the horses, because it's a bolt.
Okay.
But this one. I'm hoping it spooks, but I don't want it to spook our horse.
Spoop.
Okay. So you're attacking this dude and you're using that. So go ahead and make, yeah. Okay. And that does hit. Go ahead and roll Damaga. Whoa, that's a lot of Damaga.
Hella Damaga.
Good work. Yeah. Goodness. And, let's see. It is now, it's actually Witch Bolt, but Kim requested to change it from lightning to, ice. So that's fine.
Fancy.
Yeah, so we named it Blue Bolt. If you guys want to make any like little adjustments or whatever for your character purposes, that's totally fine. I am very flexible.
Are you very Sweet. Cool?
Very cool.
Very
cool. So yeah, you,
this guy is.
Yeah, this
not as
see,
cool
where
as,
does,
as late
where does
as
this
magic,
come from?
Though.
Where does the lightning, well in this case the cold, where does it come from?
I don't
Your it, fingertips.
Doesn't fingertips? Actually say a sword. So I guess my crystal?
Okay, sure. So this ice just erupts out of this crystal of yours and just slams into him, leaving a huge frosty part on his side. And he is reeling. He is reeling. He's struggling to stay on his horse at this point.
I grab Whitmore very tightly and I try to, I just keep eye contact on the target.
Right.
Right. Whitmore has that like, that like, I like this, but I'm not going to show it. Look on its face.
All right, Remy's up.
Okay, attack this guy.
The one that's right next to you.
Yeah, this
okay.
It's a first level spell.
Oh yes, it is. 1 second. Nothing happens.
Uh-huh. Okay. I'll just hit it with Sacred Flame.
Okay.
Oh.
Right. The dex save.
Yeah, you have to save.
Oh, he makes it. That nothing happens.
Ooh, it's embarrassing.
Anything else?
Well, I can't really move the horse.
Right, you cannot.
So I'm Gucci.
Okay. All right, thoughts up.
And I looked in the book, the mail is 16 AC and the shield is then plus 2. So if she has the shield out, she should be 18.
Yeah. Okay.
I think that's what we were doing before.
Okay. So we'll remember that from now on. Thank you.
So
it's
I'm
easier
gonna...
to... Yeah.
What?
I'll just put 16 slash. Sorry, ignore me.
Okay.
That's a good idea, putting the slash.
16 slash 18. Yeah, that's a good idea.
That's how we write it on paper, for how they write it on paper for me.
Okay.
All
right, what's that up to?
I'm going to try to whack the dude with my sword of 100 horses.
All right. Swing it, baby.
And then I guess after I roll that, I should roll a d4, I guess.
Oh, yeah, go for it.
Yeah.
Forgot about that.
Well, I'm definitely going to want to do that.
Oh, good news. Go for it.
Well, great.
Oh my god, that's perfect. That's exactly what you needed to get.
I am so blessed.
You are so blessed.
Hashtag blessed.
Hashtag blessed. All right, go ahead and swing that horse sword.
Oh, that's good.
Wait,
what? Wowzo.
Why did it? Why did it do that?
But it's the first one. Wow, yeah. You got max damage. Good for you.
It's not normal.
Well, we'll take a look at it later.
Yeah, okay.
So one is So I guess this would be if you used it as an offhand attack or a second attack, but the first one is the important one. So 12 damage. You take this dude and you carve him in half with this massive horse sword. And wow. He's dead.
Okay. Jeez.
You just one-shot him with max damage. So good show. Good first kill with that horse sword. My goodness.
I can't take that term seriously.
you don't have to. It wasn't meant to be. All right. Good work.
All right.
Do you want to let out a good whinny?
All right.
You
here.
Don't have
we'll
to.
Do, we'll do
you
this.
Don't have to.
I, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Good idea. Yeah, anytime you make a hit with it, you have to roll Constitution.
My hits? Thank you. You know how many hits I'm going to make?
Okay, fine. Every time you kill someone,
all right.
you have to do the
That's
con.
Better. All right.
And by the way, there is a way for you to not have to whinny anymore.
I bet. I bet there is.
That'll come up.
You probably anyway, wouldn't know about it.
Whitmore's turn.
Oh, man. I don't know if this is effective, but I want to do it. So okay. I'm gonna like move like up ever so slightly and then to the side, and I'm gonna stick my hand out with the movable rod in front of me and click it in front of the guy.
Oh my god!
That's
yes.
wonderful. Yep. Okay. So you go ahead and do that. I'm just gonna say you can do that.
Are you letting go of it?
Yeah, I'm letting go of the rod.
Okay.
So you are going to, it's going to stay there and it's going to just, you're going to keep going without it?
Yeah, I'm going to let go of it and let it pummel the guy in the face.
Yeah, okay. So you let go of it and he's going to roll a dex save for, I don't know. No, fuck it. That's not good enough. This dude takes an immovable rod to the face, and he goes, he gets close to the line. He has no idea what hit him. He just sees this dude holding a metal rod out in front of him, and suddenly it's in his face, and he goes backward off of his horse, and that he's gone.
All right.
I turn around and look at Lena and just say, "Remind me to retrieve that." And then
she nods because she's only half listening. she's concentrating very hard.
That'll be my turn.
Okay. Hey, can I just say that was great? Thank you for doing that. That was wonderful. All right, moving up to. The guy who just got fucking brained in the face. So he's gone. Next up is this guy who's also dead. Next up is Nefmir. I suppose you wouldn't see these guys anymore. They're long gone.
Yeah. Okay, let's see. I'll try Eldritch Blast again.
Okay.
At this fellow right here.
Okay.
With force.
With force, yeah.
Yeah.
I do, yeah.
I see where you're going.
I do see that.
Just still the advantage, yeah.
Yeah, but then we'll add 4 to whichever roll it is.
Yeah, well, let's see. Well,
wait, why is it disadvantage? Did they move?
It's disadvantage because he's also handling the horse.
He's a pilot. He's
also, no, I don't think it'd be offensive to attack the horses directly. I was considering that as well.
Like, one could attack the horses directly.
To them, it would.
I'm just going to attack. Yeah. Actually, you know what? Yeah, let's do that. Let's attack the horse directly.
Okay. Will the horse be pushed as far as the guy?
Yeah, because...
Yeah, it will.
Magic.
Like, shove the guy next to... And then try and, like, mash the guy into the horse next to him. That might not do enough.
Yeah,
maybe.
But a flying horse...
I was just thinking he would slow him down.
Exactly right about that. Probably yep. something.
So let's see. So I'm going to attack... You know, again, this horse directly. Oh, I forget. Let's see. When I roll that 1d4 in addition, like, what does that mean exactly?
Oh, so first, just do the regular attack roll. See right. if you need it. All right. Oh, you don't actually. You're fine.
Fine. Very good.
So
I'll still roll that.
Yep. One, go ahead and roll the damage. Okay. Oh, you're. Oh, I see. You're rolling that.
So that just makes it okay, a 15 now roll attack the instead of 13.
Yep.
Wait. But should I have hit Eldritch Blast?
Like, yeah. Now you just click Eldritch Blast.
Optic Blast.
Okay. So, you line up a shot on that horse, and with the help of the with the help of the blessing from Cleric Yenben, you fire off this big repelling blast, and you knock this horse with enough force to send it 10 feet, which is this direction, which means that this horse also gets tripped up pretty hard, and both of them hit the ground, and they disappear into the distance as you ride on.
Oh, me too, apparently.
Yep, she's gone. No, she's gone.
Okay, I'll just say that.
Unintentional.
I didn't want to do that.
Yeah. Wow, that was great. Good job. So this remaining guy on the horse is fucking terrified now. But, are you going to move? Remember, Thought can request movement as well.
Yeah, Thought, do you want to move at all? I think we're fine.
Yeah, we're fine.
Okay. Right,
end of turn.
All right, then we're moving on to a dead guy. And then on to Cleric Yenben, who, without turning back, shouts, "Excuse my hands, miss!" And reaches back and grabs onto your wound.
Okay.
And
he's just got a little spicy in here.
Ooh,
that's a big one. He heals you for 11.
That is more than I needed. Thank you.
You're very welcome, miss. Sorry for putting you in the line of battle like that.
It's okay. I think I'll get over it.
All right, then we're up to another dead guy. Come on, dead guy, get out of here. There we go. All right, then this horse. He doesn't like his chances, but he knows that he's got nothing better to do. So he goes for what seems to be the weakest link and attacks Lena. Like, everyone else is heavily armored in front of him.
I've got some armor.
That's true. You do have the... Oh, you're right. You do have the magic armor.
Maga armor.
But he's still going to go for you. Right, and he's got his sword out, and he whiffs. Man, he is very intimidated by this brazen display of power and ingenuity from this party in front of him. And his heart is not in it anymore. And wouldn't you know it, it's Lena's turn.
I want to use a free action to talk to him.
Okay.
So I yell as loud as I can so everyone else can hear. And I say, "Tell us who hired you, and we won't kill you."
We're making promises here.
Go ahead and roll intimidation on that.
Yeah.
Oh!
Okay.
Actually, without saying a word, though, you see his eyes like widen intensely. He doesn't say anything. He just takes the fuck off to the left, and he's gone. He fucking books it.
So those were the only ones on horses. Their words were. Did the other people on foot seem like they were gonna try to follow us?
They started at the beginning, but when the guys on horses broke out and started chasing you, they kind of slowed down. Like, what's the goddamn point?
Okay. Before we end, I just want to look at something here real quick. If I were to cast, like, Minor Illusion, the target would have to be there, or would it just be for anyone to see, like, if they came across it?
Well, eventually you're gonna leave, right?
That's true. What's the range on this?
I think there's a range, isn't there?
Oh, yeah, 30 feet. Okay, yeah, never mind. Okay.
Okay. All right. Congratulations. You've solved the horse chase puzzle.
Wait a second. As that guy left, wasn't he technically engaged with us?
Yes, he was.
Oh. Okay, I'm going to take a swing at him.
All right, do it. Wait.
Because he did not tell us, so I want to kill him.
Okay, go.
Okay.
Ooh. That hits.
Ooh.
Whoa. So
you could knock him out. You don't have to kill him.
Yeah, non-lethal blow.
It doesn't matter. It was not a one-hit kill.
Okay.
But
okay.
He's booking it, and as he does, he receives the fucking you know blunt end of a quarterstaff in his face for the trouble. His horse keeps going in the direction that he was headed originally, but you see some teeth come out.
Oh. Ah.
And he's gone.
Okay.
All right.
Wow.
Yeah.
And okay. Good job.
Now we solved your horse puzzle.
Now you've solved the horse puzzle.
Good thing I had this horse sword.
Yeah, really, yes. Though. That you guys did some really good stuff. I liked that a lot.
Can I trot back and retrieve my removable rod?
Good. Yes, you may. I was hoping you would remember that.
I let go of him a bit more now that I'm not concentrating.
Hey, you haven't gone super far or anything, but why don't you give me an investigation anyway?
I'll help him.
Okay, you get advantage then. Yep, that's enough. You get it.
All right. I don't have a hard time seeing this floating object.
Yeah, it was a pretty low check, but... but figured I probably should.
I gave it a click and just like, pretty neat, and I put it in my pocket.
It does have some blood on it.
Yeah, I was gonna say it's got blood all over it.
I try to like wipe it off on my coat a little bit and then I'll put it away.
Okay. Great. All right. So, are you guys continuing on?
I have to go pretty soon.
Yeah, for next time. I'm just asking in general.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah, well, we want to go to the
occupied ranger station.
The first ranger station, right?
Yep. So, you've already gone past that ranger station.
Yeah, we should probably go back there.
Yenben suggests we should not go back there. It's full of mercenaries.
We can't go back there. Did you see how many there were? It was an entire army.
Oh, how many did we see, Dan?
From the ones that you saw coming out, there were well over 30.
Oh my god. Never mind.
Those are just the ones you saw. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, they can have
so, before we end here, I'm actually going to... dang it, it's so far away. I need to move my maps closer together. So, here we are on the world map. And you guys are moving east. So the fight happened like right around here.
Where?
A little marker.
The little orange marker.
The little orange marker there. I wrote that very small, but you can see the two little red dots near you. The one closest says abandoned ranger station, and the one next to that says cave, because those are the two places you've been.
Okay.
Nice.
I thought this said WTF.
Well, I mean, it was Windy Boro, but maybe now after the recent events, it's going to rename to WTF.
Yeah.
So for the rest of the day, you continue traveling, and you can make it right about here, moving toward along the road to the Ranger Outpost. Before the sun starts to set behind you as you continue on. Yenben will say, I definitely do not want to move into these mountains at night. I've heard nothing but extremely, extremely bad stories about these mountains.
Okay.
Hey, Dan.
Yes.
Has it been? Has it been 8 hours?
It has been 8 hours. Yes.
Okay. And I would know, like, before my mage armor runs out, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'll make the necessary preparations for that to disappear.
Yenben suggests, I know that they, with everyone that they were carrying, they must have been moving very slow. I think we definitely have time to stop for the night, and I do not want to go into these mountains at night.
Well, I wouldn't have a problem with seeing, but I'm not opposed to making a camp. I think it's reasonable to take a rest this night.
Should we start a fire?
I think that's a good idea.
I'd like a fire.
Okay.
Can I make a check to notice what Lena's been doing with her veil?
What kind of check? Oh, you mean just to see if you have been seeing it?
Yeah, have I been paying enough attention to make note of that?
Just perception's fine.
Okay.
Well, actually, you know what? Let me see your passive perception because you're not looking for it.
It's 13.
It's 13?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can see that.
Oh, I can? All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
You've been noticing her doing that.
Can I try to figure out why she's doing that?
You mean, like, try to see what's under the veil?
Or, like, specifically, like, she's pulling it down when the armor's on, but then when the armor's not, she puts it back up before it goes away.
Mm-hmm.
So, what's up with that? Ooh.
But I don't know what you're looking for, though.
I don't know. I just want to figure out, like, why is she, like, trying to hide her face? Is there something wrong with her face? Like, what's going on?
Are you trying to guess?
I guess, yeah. Thought is trying to figure out what the deal is.
I mean, that's just kind of your own imagination, I guess, though.
Okay, so there's nothing for me to figure out.
You could... Okay, give me an insight check, okay. I guess. Give me insight. Okay, that's pretty high. Thought can, you know, can come to the general conclusion that she's hiding her face. She has that... When she has mage armor on... some of it extends over her face, and then before that armor disappears, she covers her face again, so it does seem as though she's hiding something on her face.
Okay.
Very good.
All right, anything else before we set up camp and whatnot?
Does she notice that Thought is like... Noticing,
like staring her down,
like staring me down. Yeah.
Passive perception. Oh, actually, are you nervous about it?
Yeah.
Like, are you like checking everyone to see if they're like noticing when you pull up your veil and stuff like that?
No, because I'm trying to be cool.
Okay, then passive. What's your passive?
Really high.
What's your passive? I'm asking what it is.
Where is it?
I know 16. That you are 16. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, you'll notice that he notices.
All right, cool.
All right, cool.
With my passive perception of 21, do I notice that she noticed that he noticed?
Yes. Whitmore understands all. He notices what's happening, like what she's doing with the veil. He notices that Thought is noticing, and he's noticing that Lena notices that he's noticing.
Oh god.
And that's as far as I'm going to take that.
Okay.
All right.
And also, just as a side note, as you can see from the map, very shortly after the fight on horseback, you left the forest and the road goes into more of a grasslands kind of area. And it sort of follows along a river until the river ends. And you moved on. There's a fork in the road, and you followed the road toward the mountains. I call it a road. It's a path. It's a dirt road.
Ah. Okay.
All right, and you guys are setting up camp?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, and then that's where we will stop for tonight, today.
Cool.
All of us in general. Time.
What is time?
What is time, if not a pile of lies?
A pile of lies?
It's 12 o'clock, isn't it? Isn't it 12 o'clock, you guys?
No, it's not.
Yeah, see, that's a lie.
Oh, I see.
All right, all right.